I didn't have the Sabbath as a gift from the Lord of the Sabbath, I'd probably be very, life would be a lot more routine, mundane, depressing. The Sabbath is holy time that brings you back to the Creator, back to the Lord, back to Jesus. And to remind us of where we're going, where we came from, and where we're going. It's once a week. It was made in Eden. Jesus said he made it. It's like making what do you make? Make a cake? You make something. It's a noun. You make things. Make a car. Yesterday we were driving to the Dallas Cowboy game, and I noticed there's a General Motors assembly plant there in Arlington. They make cars, or assemble cars, make cars. So he made it. Jesus said the Sabbath. In the Bible, every word has meaning. The Sabbath was made for man, as in mankind. You know why people are all distressed and high blood pressure and stressed out? Because they don't have any Sabbath. They don't take time out for God. He says work 6 days. So, people say, well, the Sabbath is every day. No, I'm sorry, it's not every day. God expects you to work, to be productive. And you'll be happier too. And then you come apart, like Pastor Carter used to say, come apart before you come apart. You come apart from the rest of the week. You set aside 24 hours to be a little bit more spiritual. It's not for the Jews, it's for man. It's such a tired, old, weak argument. It has no Bible basis. It's like saying adultery is for the Jews too. You notice they only say the Sabbath was for the Jews. What about adultery? What about lying and stealing and killing? It's a moral law. Even John Wesley upheld, all the Protestant reformers upheld the moral law. And moral means right and wrong. And right in the middle of it is the Sabbath, because it's the Creator who determines what's right and wrong. That's his badge. That's who, there's no he's the sole arbiter of what's right and wrong. You can bet Adam and Eve kept the Sabbath. Of course they did. What, did God hide it from them? He kept their little secret. He made it in the seventh day. It's the only reason there's a seventh day in the week. Oh, let's see. He made the Sabbath at the creation, but he kept it a secret from everybody until the Jews came along. That makes a lot of sense. He even says in Genesis, I don't know where it is, 18 or 26 or something, one of those, that Abraham kept my commandments, kept my laws. I like what Ellen White says about the Sabbath. She says it's the one commandment that uniquely identifies God's people throughout Scripture. And what she means is there's a lot of religions that say, you know, don't lie and don't kill and don't steal. But only the religion of the Bible has the Creator God. And his signature on creation, like a masterpiece, is his Sabbath. And by the way, it's not Jewish. He says it's my holy day. God says my holy day. Anyway, it's a beautiful time. The sun's about to go down. I hit 2 bucket of balls today. And I hit pretty Now I'm going to go have soup. My wife is with her mom and Abilene, my daughter. I'm going to bring in the Sabbath myself. I'll go to church tomorrow. Sabbath school, which I really like. And then I will, but tonight I'm going to have me some soup and some vegetarian stuff that my daughter made that she doesn't know that I'm going to eat. But that's too bad. If it's in my refrigerator, it's mine. I have rights to it. But the sun is about to go down and we enter now holy time. Try it. You'll probably stop all of the nonsense that we all do.